So in my series of videos on the two-plate method, that's where we take the feed to the switch, I only ever showed one lighting point and said you could use it for LED downlights because it reduces the number of cables at the actual lighting point compared to the three-plate method. And I've been asked the question, how would I add more lighting points when you're only showing one gas? It's quite simple, but still, for people that are learning, it's not always as simple as for those with the experience. So this was my drawing of the one-way. Okay, so that's my drawing of the one-way two-plate method. I've then got my extended one where I went on and did the two-plate method two-wayed. And again, I still only showed one lighting point, okay, in that system and said it was ideally suited for LED downlights because again, we've only got three conductors here, switching line, CPC and neutral. And we looked at the wiring diagram. And then we went on to do our two-way and intermediate switching using the two-plate method, okay? So we had the two-plate method here. And again, I only showed one lighting point. So what we've got here, obviously, is our LED downlights that we're probably replicating. And it's unlikely you'd have one, say, in a kitchen. So you'd have six, eight, whatever there is. So, of course, you're going to need to add multiple lighting points in. So how can you do that, Gaz? Remember, this is the connecting area, and it could be that the LED downlight has a connecting area on it, which would be two switching lines, two CPCs and two neutrals as shown here. Okay, so you're bringing it in and going out and doing the next lighting point. The end lighting point would also have one cable in it, but all the others have possibly got the two in it and the in and the out. Okay, we also said that that section there could be a joint of some sort where the cables come into it, whether it be like any of the ones that I'm showing you now. Another position to make connections, so in other words, where we can make a connector. So let's imagine we wanted to put another downlight in circuit. So we've got our LED downlight and we want more than one in that kitchen area. So we're going to bring another circle with three connecting points. Let's bring another circle over here with three connecting points. Okay, so it's a simple case of just having a 1mm squared for me, twin and CPC cable, or twin and earth. So we've got brown, blue, and a bare conductor, which we will identify with green and yellow sleeving as our CPC. So we've got switching line, neutral, and CPC, and it works the same for all three circuits that we've looked at, whether they be the one-way, the two-way, or the intermediate in this case. So all we're gonna do is we're going to bring into this connector here and into this connector here, which is connected to an LED light, connected to an LED light, and we carry on. So we go from here, we bring out our neutral connection. We're going to bring out our switching line connection. And we're going to bring out our CPC into the next light point. So remembering which way we're connecting, it might be in a joint or it might be in the fitting itself. So all we've brought across here is switching line, neutral and CPC, and when this circuit is in the on position, the first light will be on and obviously the second light will be on, and we just repeat the process. So all we're going to do is introduce another 1mm squared twin and CPC cable from this lighting point to this one, bringing across our CPC, switching line and neutral into the appropriate connections and repeat the process again. So let's do that. So we bring across our CPC like so to our next point in the kitchen, say. We bring across our switching line, and we're going to bring across our neutral into here. So again, using the appropriate cable, remember we need to identify our CPC with our green and yellow sleeving over the top of it. So what you can see now is that when we're on this light and this lighting point, and you carry the process on. Imagine we've gone to six or seven of these first. You can see the last LED downlight only has one cable in it and the remaining ones all have two in them. And that's what they're designed to do. So if you look at the connection on the back here, this is designed to take a cable in and a cable out, a cable in and a cable out as you repeat the process in this style of them. If you're making your own connections or joints, obviously that's slightly different. You have to put your connectors in. But that's common what happens now. On the back of an LED light fitting, there is the facility to bring in a neutral and out a neutral, a CPC in and out, and a switching line in and out in order that you can loop between multiple downlights. It's not ideal to try and bring three into one. So if I came from here to here and here to here, that's not ideal for the connections in here. You go to one, you go to the next one, you go round to the next one. And we can have as many as can be designed into the installation. So we've often seen six and eight in kitchens and things like that. And this time we've got two-way and intermediate switching. Remember, you could have been looking at my one-way lighting circuit. and this would have been changed. Same method going on too, but then you'd only have a one-way switch in order to control it. And we could have been using the two-way either. Yeah, it doesn't matter which ones we're looking at. So that's what we would do to add. How can we add more lighting points to our two-plate method? It's a simple case of coming from the lighting point you've wired, a switching line, neutral, CPC, and carrying on the process. So as always, I hope this video has been some help.